Hi and welcome to my ninth video in this series, and today we're going to be looking at protein synthesis. So in some of the earlier videos we've discussed how genetic material is organised, and so the smallest subunit of genetic material is DNA, and DNA goes on to form genes. Genes are found on chromosomes, and chromosomes are found within the nucleus of a cell. And looking back specifically at DNA, if you remember that DNA is made of three major parts. You have a ribose sugar, a phosphate group, and in the middle, if you see on these diagrams, you've got the nucleotide bases. And of these nucleotide bases, there are four, A, T, C, and G. Their full names are adenine, thymine, cysteine, and guanine. And it's these bases that combine in very specific ways. So adenine always binds to thymine, and guanine always binds to cytosine. And it's the order of the nucleotide bases that enables the cells to make proteins, and proteins are the building blocks of life. So the muscles that you're made of, the chemicals that control the reactions within your cells, those are usually controlled by proteins, and it's the sequence of DNA that determines what protein you'll make. And so proteins are made of a chemical called amino acids, so loads of amino acids put together would form a protein. Some proteins, dependent on their function, can be quite small, so several hundred amino acids long, whereas others can be much more complex and much longer and can be several thousand or tens of thousands of amino acids long. So if we take an example of a protein that's 100 amino acids long, think of all the possible ways that you could arrange 20 different types of amino acids. So you could have 20 of the or 100 of the same amino acids all in a row, and you could do that with all 20. So there's 20 ways of arranging it. Or you could have two amino acids going concurrently, so having one, then another, then the first one, then the second, and so on and so forth. But you probably get an idea of just how complex and how varied proteins can be. And so that's why they're so useful, because they come in a variety of different types and they can serve a variety of different functions. Now, because there are 20 amino acids we need to code for, we get to something called the triplet code. Now, if you think about it, if you only had one base coding for one amino acid, then you could only ever make four amino acids. So either A would code for one amino acid, T, thymine, would code for another, cytosine would only code for one, and guanine, so therefore four. But if you use two bases in a row, then you could produce 16. By this I mean the code could be AA, that would be one various code you could have, AT would be another, AC or AG. And there in total, if you use two bases, there are 16 codes that you could have. But that's not enough to code for the 20 amino acids you use or need. But if you use three bases, then you can code for up to 64 amino acids. So therefore, DNA is a triplet code, because those 64 codes that you could possibly use, because it's a triplet code, one example might be adenine, so AAA, that would be one. Adenine, guanine would be a second. So by having a triplet code, you have 64 permutations. So you could code for up to 64 amino acids. And because there are only 20, this is enough. Now, because there are only 20 amino acids and there are 64 base triplets that you could use to code for them, obviously this is too many. So what ends up happening genetically is a triplet or different triplets can code for the same amino acid. And there's a specific word to explain that, and it's called degenerate. So for instance, a certain code, AAT, might code for a certain amino acid, and the code AAC might also code for the same amino acid. And that word to describe that is called degenerate. So looking here at a typical piece of DNA, this DNA has been uncoiled, so it's just been represented by these two strands here. So we're going to just take the left-hand one of these for the while, and then hence why we're using it here. Okay, so these correspond to this code here, and it's a non-overlapping code, which means that one of the nucleotide bases only belongs to one triplet code, so we divide it into three, so ATT, CGA, GC, and GGT. So in summary, the genetic code is a triplet code, so that means the nucleotides are found in threes. It's a degenerate code, that means that one or more triplets can code for the same amino acid. It's non-overlapping, that means that a nucleotide base belongs to a specific triplet and is read as such. And it's universal. You'll find that the genetic code for a specific protein found in humans, or also found in other simians or other organisms, is the same.